Marion Guilloux, the environmental crisis and the health crisis seem to be forcing us to rethink our agricultural and food system. And at the same time, since no food shortages have really occurred yet during quarantine, isn't there a risk that some people might try to avoid reflecting on such matters?
Well, maybe you have two timelines to look at. You know, the urgency and the crisis of COVID and how to manage the end of the crisis and the fact that we relaunch the economy, and that's, you know, short and medium term, let's say 2 years or something like that. And you have the long-term tendencies, and they are still there, of course. I mean, climate change has not been influenced by COVID. I mean, there will be a slight decrease in greenhouse gases emission, but we know that it is very temporary and that it will come back. So it's not a long-term tendency. So we have to concentrate on the long-term anyway, as we had before the COVID crisis. So I think it doesn't change the main tendencies. And so what we realized during the crisis is that, in fact, you should be careful about food security, more careful than we were before about food security at regional level and not only at global level, and that you should be careful about what we called essential goods requirements, you know, so that you are sure that the population can have access to food and health products in the coming years. So I think that's the main lesson that could be drawn for that. And of course, we have to be very careful of the social situation in the coming months.
So there is a lot of talk these days about food sovereignty, and as we know, the agricultural market is globalized and farmers are increasingly managing large farms to produce on a large scale and sell their stocks around the world. So how can we ensure an ecological transition without causing production at a loss and food waste, for example?
You have to think about the incentives to get the production you feel is good for the economy and for the environment. But you need financial incentives so that the farmers make the change. I mean, they need the real economic incentive to do that. Of course, you know that at the moment there is a CAP reform that is in discussion. And of course, it's a very good opportunity to think about how to give the good incentives so that we decrease the greenhouse gases emission, so that we increase the production of the goods we are missing in Europe. So the signal could come from the new CAP, and of course, the discussion are in that framework at the moment. If we talk about food sovereignty, I prefer to talk about food security. That is to say, how do you make sure that your population can have access at the right price, in good quantity, in good quality, to the food it needs? And when you think about the world situation, some countries will always need to import food. I mean, the Middle East and African countries are net importers, and globally, not all the countries one by one, but globally, this zone in the world will always need a lot of imports, and increasingly, because the population is increasing very quickly. And at the same time, with climate change, you will have natural disasters in big producing countries from time to time. Think about the Australian drought that has been terrible, and so that the cereal production decreased a lot. And so there again, you need a food trade to compensate. So food trade will always be there in the landscape and for many years.
It was often believed that technological innovations would save the agricultural sector, whether it is mechanization or chemistry. The current situation inspires doubt. So how do you imagine the agriculture of tomorrow, Marion Guillou?
Well, first, we have, before saying that technology is finished, we have to remember that it will stay there and we'll need different technologies. I mean, obviously, mechanization is still useful. You know, computers will help during precision farming, and precision farming will help to spare some fertilizers, to spare greenhouse gases emission, and to adapt the dose that we need to the plant at the right time, right place. So yes, you know, some what you call technology or some techniques are there to improve our way to farm in our country. So I think technology is not finished. We need technology in agriculture, but it will be different technologies and more adapted to local conditions. But, you know, computerization helps for that. You can do custom-made solutions. And in fact, the agroecology needs custom-made solutions.